Looking for a way to get healthy? The Chef You and I program has the answer. Catherine Raker and chefs from around the nation will teach even the most inexperienced how to cook. Come into their kitchen and watch them take ordinary foods with loads of calories and fat and turn those foods into healthier dishes. You will be the first to get tips and ideas on foods that are easy to prepare. Now let's join Catherine and today's chef and learn how to make today's recipes.
Hi, this is Catherine Raker of The Chef You and I with Father Andrew Umberg, my favorite pastor who loves to cook, and he's a culinary chef as well. You know, tonight we are doing something really wonderful. I love fish. You know, I like fish a lot. And we're doing a cheese ball?
Yes, first a cheese ball.
First a cheese ball, and then we're going to do my, what kind of salad?
I forget the name of it already.
It's there.
Oh, your arugula salad. And what?
And
gorgonzola. And gorgonzola, nice.
Yes, nice. With pears.
With pears.
Right? And it's going to be delicious, actually. So we're going to have that for salad. Then we're doing what else, Father?
Okay, so the cheese ball, then we have the salad. Then we are making a pasta with a smoked salmon cream sauce on it. Yeah, it should be nice. It's going to be a light cream sauce, so
light
just
cream.
Half and half.
Oh, that's what I did for you.
Yeah,
I did that for you. And these are fresh Brussels sprouts we're going to have.
Fresh Brussels sprouts, and we're going to saute them.
Right.
And with a little bit of onion and butter and olive oil.
Ooh.
Yeah, I hated Brussels sprouts as a kid.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, and this is the way I actually like them.
Really? You know? I haven't tried them like that before.
Yeah, the house still might smell a little bit like Brussels sprouts, but they taste good.
That's the important thing.
I enjoy them. I say more Brussels sprouts, which is a miracle in itself.
Okay, so my other thing is that we're going to make a cod tonight as well, because some people don't like salmon. We won't mention their names. Anyhow, and it's done with wine. It's done in the oven. Mm-hmm. It's done with wine. It's done with butter. It's done with crackers, rice crackers.
Nice.
Right? With a little bit of salt and pepper chives. And it's one of the things I love to make. And I love cod. Okay. I like salmon too.
And I'm a salmon lover, and that's why I'm going to blacken a little bit of salmon.
Okay.
I'm going to cook it in Cajun seasoning anyway.
Okay. All right.
I figure salmon with a salmon pasta. I don't mind overdoing the salmon.
Yeah, I know you don't. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is you're going to show us how to do this cheese dip ball.
Cheese ball. This is about 8 ounces of cream cheese, what you buy at the store. I happen to have. Had a big brick of it, so it's a little bit different shape than what you'd see there.
Right.
But it's about 8 ounces. So you put an 8-ounce brick of cream cheese in a bowl. You microwave it a little bit at about half power for just a minute to get it a little bit warm. So it's workable.
That's workable.
Yeah, otherwise, you know, it's just you end up fighting with it too much.
Right.
Yes. So what I'll do with this is I'll take one of your measuring spoons here. And with this is the teaspoon.
Right.
I'll take a good solid 2 teaspoons of chopped garlic from the jar.
Wonderful.
Okay. And then maybe a little bit more, just in case 2 wasn't enough. Okay.
Word.
And then I'm going to break and then I need a little bit of salt. Can I have
a salt shaker? Salt shaker. How about this coarse salt? Can you handle
that'll
that?
Be good. Sure, I think that'll be fine.
Okay.
Because we just want to salt the garlic a little bit. Again, I am convinced that gets the oils coming out. Yeah, try to hit the garlic the best you can.
I am. I hit it.
Okay, that's good. That's good. Wonderful.
Do you want pepper?
Okay. No pepper, thank you. We're going to put some red pepper in a minute, though.
Okay.
Some cayenne pepper.
Cayenne pepper.
Yeah, this cheese ball has
a kick?
Yeah, there's some flavor movements. First, you just taste the cream cheese just for an instant.
Yeah.
Then you taste the next ingredient, which is a steak sauce. You buy the steak sauce shaped in the bottle shaped like this.
Yeah.
You know, there's one that with a number on it, and this happens to be a grocery store's knockoff of it that also has its own number.
Right.
But anyway, you take some of that, and you pour in, for 8 ounces, you know, a tablespoon and a half, 2 tablespoons.
Right.
You can hardly overdo it. If you don't have this or you don't want to buy this and you have Worcestershire sauce,
you can
put that in instead. And not quite as much.
Okay.
Because this is a little bit thicker. And if you put too much watery stuff in with cream cheese in, cheese ball ends up sweating a little bit, and it's just not as nice.
Right.
I mean, it doesn't have that nice creamy texture that you want. So as
That smells so good, even though it's got garlic in it. That's all right.
And garlic is part of the thing, but yeah, that the steak sauce really has a lot of nice flavors in it. I'm at the end of the bottle here, but I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit more in. See, look at that. We're getting a little bit more flavor.
Wow.
And it turns it kind of a nice, kind of peachy orange color.
Really?
Okay. And that's about where you want it.
Okay, and then you put the...
And then once I get this mixed a little bit more...
Yeah.
I just want to... We've got some big white splotches in there still, and I want to make sure
it
all gets cream cheese. Okay.
Okay.
Then I'll take about a quarter teaspoon of cayenne pepper.
Quarter teaspoon of cayenne pepper.
And, of course, a heaping one because that's the way I do things.
Yeah, you're really into that.
Yeah. Okay, that's enough. I'll calm down because we're going to put that on the outside of it, too.
Oh, you are?
Yes. So,
ooh.
So we mix it up and we get it, though, so it's here throughout. So you taste the cream cheese, then you taste the steak sauce, you taste the garlic, you taste the steak sauce, and then when it all melts away, you've got a mouthful of cayenne pepper, and that's a good punch there at the end. It's very
right,
nice.
Right.
At least if you like, real strong, tangy flavors.
Yeah,
which
I do.
I do. And okay.
Do you make this at Christmas time?
I do. This is one of my standard snacks
for Christmas.
Yeah, for
I got
Christmas,
you one. I got one for you too. Hmm? My Swiss cheese ball.
Oh gosh, okay.
My Swiss cheese dip.
Nice,
I had to give it to you.
Nice.
Ooh, that looks good.
Yeah, see, so you get this, again, it's kind of a pinky color. Really, it's almost salmon color, even though there's no salmon in this, smoked or otherwise, okay?
And then you serve that with, you refrigerate it,
well,
right?
Well, see, then the next step will be if I can have like a piece of plastic wrap.
Sure.
And then that's how we'll form the cheese ball.
Okay, just a minute. We need our producer to hand us some of that. Okay.
Great.
And then what we're going to do, here we go. The magic of television.
And if you can give me another one of those knives, just like
regular knife.
Yeah, regular knife.
Right. Okay. Keep going.
Okay. So
don't you love this?
We're going to get a piece of this here
and cut
it off. You've got the nice zippy one there.
Yeah, I like that.
And then I'm going to take this and put this in here. Because you don't want to fight with this once.
Once it's done?
Yeah. I don't think it's... I mean, by then, I'm about eating then, and I'm not about fighting then once it's... Because it has to sit in the refrigerator.
For how long?
I think it's ideal 8 hours. I think it's really nice to do it the night before or at least the morning of your party.
Okay.
You know, before work, it doesn't take that long to do if you know what you're doing.
Right.
First time, probably you should do it maybe the first couple times, maybe the night before to make sure all those flavors get together. Otherwise... It tastes very different now than it will
eight hours from now.
Yeah.
Now you did one ahead of time.
We did.
Right.
So yeah. So,
so we can show it in a second.
Yes,
right.
Yes. So
if you wrap that up.
So together. And see, I'm making sure I don't get in the corners in. So then I'll go ahead and form the cheese ball the way I want it. Okay. And
that's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's nice.
It's like doing pie dough.
Yeah, it's not
right.
And again, I'm not a perfectionist with regard to this. It'll still have a little bit of pock marks there, but that's okay. It'll be nice. And then we put it in the refrigerator.
Okay. And then by magic of what?
The magic of television.
We have another one. And
there's one that's all ready to go.
And I'm going to get to a plate.
Yeah, a little saucer or a plate would be great.
How about this?
That would be, fancy.
Yeah, why not?
Fancy schmancy.
Okay, and we've got crackers.
Okay, and I put this in a couple of layers here.
Just a minute, I'm going to move your bowl. Just a second.
That's great. Okay, and then away we go. And again, you want to have a paper towel or something ready here to clean up when you get a little bit on the edges there. Oh, that wasn't too bad though, really.
Yeah.
And let me throw this over here.
And, you know, it's so much fun doing this, especially if we're getting into all of the holidays now. And, you know, when you have a lot of company, you just want to have things ready, you know. Make it easy on yourself. Don't kill yourself.
Okay, now this time I'm just taking maybe an eighth teaspoon of cayenne.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to hit this like this.
Ooh.
And then, see, that's like warning everybody. You know, You know, that they say poisonous snakes usually are brightly colored. Well, I like to warn people, you know, with bright, you know, cayenne colors that there's cayenne in the thing so that they're not running around my living room afterwards saying, asking for water, you know? They might anyway, but anyway. So there you go.
Okay,
but
let's do this. Let's do this.
Okay, before we do this, to get it on the edges, see, some falls on there, and I hit it like that, and sometimes it actually works, and then it looks nicer. Okay, then let's go ahead and fill those right on in.
Okay, let's just do that. That'll look really sweet.
Now, you want to get this out and set up like this at least an hour before your party.
Yeah.
And as it gets warmer and warmer, that, you know, there's less and less movement, but wow, you get all those flavors at once eventually. I kind of like the movement, but then at the end, I've warned people that this is a highly addictive, a highly addictive high cholesterol drug. You got to stay away from it because, you know, it's a little bit dangerous once it's been sitting around in an overheated room with a lot of guests there.
Yeah, it becomes like that. Right.
It's hard to stop.
It's hard to stop. That's
hard
what
to stop
my
at the fifth that,
now that's what my Swiss cheese dip is like.
Oh, okay. Well, let right? me see that knife. I think we better sample. That's an important part.
Well, you are going to sample, and we'll give the producer a sample. But in the meantime, are we going to take a little break and then come back and do that? How about that?
That sounds
we'll take a little break, and we'll be right back on The Chef You and I with Catherine Raker and Father Andrew Umberg. We're back on The Chef You and I with my favorite priest, Father Andrew Umberg, and he's a culinary chef, and he came up with this wonderful dip, and he was telling me during the break that his mom taught you this when you were 10.
Yes, yes. It used to be on the steak sauce bottle, but it's kind of my version of it. It's my memory of it, you know, 30 years later.
Okay, so show us what it looks like now.
Okay, so we've... You know, if you want a lot of cayenne, you go from the outside. You could scoop some of that off. But again, remember, we stirred it throughout.
Yeah.
And you put it on there and see, you can just barely see any little specks of cayenne in there.
Right.
But anyway, and then by the way, the producer approves completely of it.
Okay.
Got my
you got your
peas and garlic.
Mm. Right. Well, there is a spice out there that is similar to garlic that I can actually eat.
Well, next time,
Colonel Stewart makes it. Mm. It's his spices. So we'll go downtown and we'll get some of his spice. Mm. So, does that sound good?
That sounds great. I'm noticing nothing's ever staying on the hors d'oeuvre plate. It's going straight from the cracker to my mouth on the plate, but that's okay.
Right. So now that we've done that, and that'll serve how many people, would you say?
Oh, I'd say,
12?
Assuming it's part of other hors d'oeuvres, 12 people. Yeah.
12 people.
That's a nice
one. Okay, so that's a really, really nice hors d'oeuvre, and you can put that back in the refrigerator.
It keeps for months anyway.
Right, months,
see,
right.
Because it's got the vinegar that's in the steak sauce, the cayenne and the garlic.
Okay,
really nice.
That's good. So are we going to do the salad next, or let's get the fish in the, or let's get the fish done, because the salad takes 10 minutes, 5 minutes.
Okay.
Really.
Okay, now the fish, okay.
Do you want to do the pasta first?
Well, let's go ahead and have your fish put in the oven, because my fish is going to be cooked on... Remember, I'm
going to
try it there. So.
Okay, so if you don't mind, I'm going to take a little short break, go get my fish, and we're going to do that. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. We're back on The Chef You and I, and Father's going to do the pasta, start the pasta, and I'm going to do the cod. We're going to do my cod, and then you're going to do the Brussels sprouts, right?
Correct.
Okay, so you go ahead and do, what are you going to do first, Father?
Well, I'm going to throw some salt in the water there.
All right.
I'm going to throw in...
maybe a teaspoon.
About a teaspoon into the water for a lot of pasta there.
Right.
You know what? It doesn't hurt a thing to put a little bit more in.
Right.
Because this is just the water anyway.
Right.
I have heard of an Italian once over in Rome. I heard an Italian tell somebody that the water should be as salty as the Mediterranean. So
that's
we're moving toward the Mediterranean.
Right.
There,
so that's already boiling, by the way.
Yes, yes. We have it going.
We have it going. So you could actually go ahead and do that.
And we're going to use two kinds of pasta here. I like mixing these two. These are the same two I used for the other one, but I just like this because it's a nice chewy blend that holds the sauce really nice.
Yeah,
I don't do this with everything. But.
Right, and you know, we're going to Rome, so are we going to be getting this in Rome?
Well, we can try.
We can try. You know, pasta is different in Rome than it is here. I mean, it's not like it's a meal. It's like a side dish.
It is, and that's how we're using it tonight, right?
We're
going to have the salmon and the Brussels sprouts and the cod with it.
I mean,
the choice. So this is Italian campanelle, okay, which means little bells.
Little bells?
And they kind of look like bells because it's rolled up together into a bell.
Oh,
see that?
Look
like
at that. Bell. That's cute.
Yeah, and then this is rigate, which means it's got the little ridges on it, okay? It's got the little ridges. And we're going to, this cooks 9 to 11 minutes, which means 9 minutes for us at most.
Right.
And I'm going to put about half the bag in.
Okay. Do you mix it with the other pasta or
do I do, I do, but I'm going to wait a few minutes first.
Okay, because that other pasta only takes 7 minutes, right?
Yes, which really means six.
6 minutes?
Yeah, I don't trust all, I always go a little bit less.
Okay.
Okay, so the other pasta we'll be using is rotini, just regular rotini. It looks like the little corkscrews, kind of, okay?
Right.
So we're ready to go with this. I'll put that in just a moment.
Okay. In the meantime, I know you're going to be chopping up the Brussels sprouts.
Yes. You've already kindly washed
them
and then cut the little bottom of the nub off them. But I like to split them down the middle. To cook them the way I like to cook them, I have to split them down the middle. So I'm doing that with a knife while you're preparing the cod.
Okay, so the first thing I did with the cod was I put lemon and white wine, and I used a dry white wine, and I actually marinated the cod in it, Father. So then the next thing I'm going to do, I took and I made rice crackers, mm-hmm. Which is kind of like the rice, not pasta, but the rice, you know, covering that you use. And so I did that in one of those fast blender things, right?
Mm-hmm.
Bullets. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the pasta, I'm going to take the fish, right, which is, like I told you, I had already done everything with, and then you're just going to put this lightly on it, right, just
nice.
A little bit, and then you're going to put it in a glass pan that I used that I already put olive oil in, okay, and then you just put that right there.
Nice.
So okay.
A little olive oil in that.
I use the spray.
Yes,
I use the spray. I like it a lot. It's really good. And then you put this in for about 30 minutes on 400 degrees.
Good. Yeah, fish is so delicate. It's nice to not have to fight with it as you're
right.
getting it out of the
right. So now we're gonna put this in the oven. And I have to walk over here for a minute. Just
okay.
a second.
Okay.
And we're gonna put that in the oven and then it'll cook for, like I said, 25-30 minutes. And unfortunately, I forgot to turn the oven on. Oh, well, it doesn't take that long. I love
so
these new...
So you're preheating that to what temperature?
400.
Again, 400. So it really kind of blasts this. That's nice.
It does blast it. And
nice.
It doesn't take long on my gas stove. You
well,
have a gas stove.
Almost. Yeah. Oh, yes.
Don't you love gas? It's so much easier to work with than electric. And I actually had to put the gas in.
Oh, gosh, it was worth it, though, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Every moment of it.
I'm going to dump this other pasta in
okay.
now that we've gone a couple of minutes here.
Okay.
And I should give this pasta a little bit of a stir, too.
Okay, you need
a spoon of any kind. Any
right,
kind
use this
spoon.
One.
Wonderful.
Okay.
And then I'll
and his
like
pasta
this.
Is always delicious. We had a tuna pasta, which we have the recipe on that he did a few months ago, and it's really, really, really good. So, we're going to use a mirror. Now, so tell me what you're going to do with the Brussels sprouts.
Okay, with the Brussels sprouts, once I get them all cut, I'm going to fry them in a skillet with some butter and olive oil. We could go all butter, and it would taste even better.
You want to do that?
But I want to live to 60, you know, so I try to cut
good.
The butter
I'd like
some
to
of
live
time.
To 90.
Yeah,
how about
okay.
that?
So anyway,
right?
yeah, oh, yeah, well, I'm hoping to... Probably I'll make it to 90, considering the
yes.
longevity
so I,
genes.
I actually got some butter for you.
Okay.
And I have the wonderful...
So we'll go half and half. Maybe,
half and half.
Maybe even two-thirds butter, but we just don't want to...
Do you want a stick or what?
It. Oh, no. Like
half a stick?
A third of a stick will be more
a third
than
third of a stick.
Let's even go a quarter. Let's see how skinny we can make this.
Okay, so we're going to take a little break, and we'll be right back just after these messages. We're back on The Chef, You and I, with Father Andrew Umberg and myself, Catherine Raker. And Father Umberg had actually just chopped all the Brussels sprouts, except for a few. And the next thing you're going to do, Father, is chop the onion.
Yes, I'm putting these Brussels sprouts
into what?
The Bagwell.
And why do you like that Bagwell?
Because it holds the bag open for you.
But you know what? Here's the cool thing. I got to give them a little mention on our show because they've been with us for so many years. Actually, you can store. So you do spaghetti sauce, marinara sauce, right? This is the greatest invention ever. Oh. It's hands-free.
And I can get meatballs in there,
yes,
too. Once they cool
yes.
off, just bam, right
and
in there.
You can take them on a camping trip, too. It's great. It's wonderful. Okay, so what you're doing now is you're chopping up your onion. How much are you chopping it?
Well, we have a medium onion. That's all peeled, ready to go. And a third of it I'm going to use for the Brussels sprouts.
Okay.
You
do you want me
what?
To chop
I'm
those
gonna
up?
Go, I mean, this isn't an exact science. I'm going to go almost a half.
Why
and we're
not?
We're going to use the other half for the salmon cream sauce.
Okay.
Okay? So, let's see. If you don't mind, I'll go ahead and just get this, you know, nicely diced.
Right.
I'm a little bit cautious here. This is a ceramic knife, and I'm not used to using that.
Actually,
thing.
They're very cool.
Mm-hmm.
Very easy to use, and they're ergonomically great for your hand.
Oh.
Especially if you like to cook a lot.
Mm-hmm. And I do.
We
I've
know.
I've got a pretty good callus right here on my finger.
Tell me something.
From other cooking.
How much do you cook a week?
You know, there are weeks where I'll cook like two or three things, like a pot of stew, a thing of soup, maybe a pie or something
whatever.
Like that. And then there are weeks that I'll go without cooking a thing. It's funny. And then there's Christmas party season where I'm cooking away.
Right.
In the fall, I think the fall is the most beautiful time of the year.
Right.
I've put like, you know, autumn leaves and fake pumpkins in my dining room. And I love to have at least one dinner party then. So I'm hoping to do
well,
that.
I have a surprise for you tonight.
Oh, what's that?
I have your Christmas wreath done.
Oh, nice, nice.
So, right, and I got a request to do a white wreath this year.
Okay.
White and silver. Okay. So I'm doing that next. But okay, so now you're done without. Now what's next?
Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take some of this wonderful olive oil that you have.
Right.
And I'm going to put it in a skillet. And this will be our... we won't turn it on yet, though. We're going to wait because the Brussels sprouts, and then I'm going to put some of this in here then. We're putting some more in here. This is going to be our salmon cream sauce.
Okay.
But we have some things to do first, and I'll need a little bit more. Then I'm also going to put some butter in each of these things.
Okay.
Again, you know, we've cut the butter some.
Right.
I've got a third of a stick.
Right.
I'm going to put that in for our salmon cream sauce. That's nice and buttery.
Okay.
And then I'm going to put almost another third, maybe a quarter, so 2 tablespoons of butter in with this olive oil.
Okay.
And that's going to be for the Brussels sprouts.
Okay. So what are you going to make first?
Okay. I'm getting this all ready so the Brussels sprouts can come together at the end because the Brussels sprouts...
Don't
and
take
I think
long.
And any vegetable... I can't stand when a vegetable overcooks in its own vegetable-iness. Yeah, so
it doesn't taste good.
So I also want, if you have that little scooper, I'm going to take this onion and
Put
this in the pan. So we're going to get that all ready. Everything's going to be ready to go.
There
and then
you
at
go.
The end, I can just really quickly saute these vegetables. So
and give me the other one. Thank
so
you.
So in goes
that.
In goes the onion.
Just tell me when you turn when to turn it on.
Okay, and then we'll put we'll let the onion saute a little bit in the butter and olive oil before we put in the Brussels sprouts, okay?
Okay.
So good. So that's all ready to go.
Okay.
So now we start on the pasta.
Right.
The cream sauce. Again, I've got what looks like about a quarter cup of olive oil.
Right.
And a third of a stick of butter.
Right.
Which is not quite...
Are you making like a roux?
Not really. I won't be putting any flour in it.
That's the difference. So it's definitely
okay,
a cream sauce.
And we need to pour out our pasta now.
Okay, let me
and
show
I
you
need
something.
A little bit of help. We need
let
to pour the
do,
pasta immediately.
Let you
then.
Get
okay.
in the front, and I'll get in the back.
Okay, sounds
all
great.
Right.
Good thing I'm skinny. I can walk right around here. Okay. In goes the pasta. Okay, so that's ready to go.
Okay, your pasta's... So, everyone, I actually drained the pasta. It looks really, really nice. And we're going to put that back on the stove that doesn't have any heat on it. Right in the back.
Sorry, I'll move it right there.
Right here in the back.
Okay, great. Okay. We'll put those here for now.
Okay.
Okay, so now we are ready to start making our cream sauce.
Okay, so the first thing you do is you turn it on, you put it... Oh, you're going to do it in the back?
I'll have it on the back burner, if that's okay.
Okay, that's fine.
And then I've got to get busy here with the onion.
Okay.
I'm using the other knife this time.
And I'm going to watch it for you while you're doing that. Do you want me to watch it?
Okay, that would be wonderful.
Okay, so I'm going to get this little beautiful piece out here.
Wonderful. And then?
Okay.
We're chopping the onion. We're kind of mincing it, you know. Again, we don't have to be real scrupulous about it. It can... We can have some little chunks of onion, and it's still nice, I think.
That's good.
And people, you know, it answers the question, what's
in here? What's really nice is that people don't, you know, actually butter's better for you and easier to digest, actually. Mm-hmm. Unless your doctor says you can't ever have butter. I use it for everything, and everything in moderation is really not bad at all, right?
Exactly.
And that's the most important thing, I think. So I'm watching the butter. It's looking good.
And this
meal
is for a lot of folks. So.
It's almost there, Father.
Okay. And what I'll do now.
You're going to have to put the cream in just a second.
Okay.
Do you remember making cream tuna when you were a kid?
No. My mom never ended up making that. So, and I didn't learn that one.
You
here
did?
Here we go.
It?
I'm coming in here with this.
All right. Okay, and we're going to let that sauté, right?
Just a little bit, yes. We're going to let it sweat a little bit, but then there's something else very important that we need to do.
And what's that? What's that, Father?
We need to put in the salmon. So, first I need to cut up the salmon.
Okay.
So that's the next phase. So what we have here
is you've got two kinds of
salmon.
You've got two kinds of salmon.
And we'll just use this one. This is just smoked salmon, one pack of it from the deli. It doesn't look like a lot of smoked salmon, but that is a very strong flavor.
Really?
And when that gets in there with that butter and that oil, it will be very
unbelievable.
Powerful. Yes, it'll be delicious. So.
You're cutting that up.
Yeah, I don't know of any really good advice other than use a nice sharp knife and do your best to get it in the smallest pieces possible. You know, we're not trying to have big chunks of salmon. We just, you know, we just want...
Enough
so it's
pieces?
Throughout. Yeah, little tiny pieces throughout. So, okay, so I'm going to try going like this. And
when you were
nice.
In the seminary, did you cook for anybody?
No, never really got a chance to as a seminarian.
Really?
They didn't have a good kitchen then at the time.
Oh.
They've changed that because now they want the priests, when they're off alone, you know, not to just be eating out of a fast food bag their entire life,
right,
you know.
Right.
That doesn't help anything.
No.
It used to be when... several priests lived in a rectory, there'd be a cook.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that.
Yeah, so that was
And
nice.
Actually, I'm letting that sweat, you know. Right
okay,
here.
Yeah, if you kind of stir it around a little bit, that would probably be a wonderful idea.
I am doing
idea.
That. I am
okay,
doing that.
Okay, and so we've got this together. Okay. We've minced up the salmon.
Mm-hmm.
And now, yes, if I can have both of these, and I'm going to go ahead and...
Yeah, that's wonderful.
Okay, so the onion is sweating,
yes.
I'm assuming.
Yes.
Nice, and then
that's
we'll go
easy.
Like,
very, yes. Very easy.
Okay. Look at that.
When is Lent this year? In February?
It starts almost as late as it can, and within a few days, it starts in March this year.
Oh, yeah. Wow!
I think maybe even March 1st is Ash Wednesday. March
really?
1st or March 4th or something like that. Yeah.
Oh wow!
So it's later. Oh, okay.
So
there's our salmon-y. Stuff here.
Okay. What are you going to do? Can I ask a question? Are you going to do the other salmon too? Are you going to bake the other salmon?
We're going to fix that in this electric skillet.
Oh, okay.
And maybe we can go ahead and move that on over so we can go ahead and get that started. So we have our onions and our salmon, and they're cooking in the butter and oil. Okay. Again, about a third of a stick of butter and about a quarter cup of oil. And about a half of a medium onion and one pack of salmon. Now that's already salty, but we're putting cream in, or at least half and half to make it a little bit lighter. So I'm gonna add a little bit more. And then if we go ahead then now that oil has that that smoked salmon flavor, it's very powerful, and you go ahead and pour that cream in then, or the half and half. Go ahead and pour in 2/3 of the thing at least.
That enough?
Yes. How much did you have there? A total of 2 cups?
About 2 cups.
Yeah, go ahead and put a little bit more in. See, and if you undercook the pasta a little bit, that makes it so that once you get this hot, when you add the pasta to it, it kind of soaks in, and then the pasta then has even more flavor.
Ooh, that's wonderful.
I think it's
nice. That's great.
Okay.
That's great. So you're going to stir that for how long?
Until it gets hot.
Until it gets
hot.
And
then I'm going to turn it off.
And then you're going to put it on the pasta?
I can reheat it at the moment we want to serve it. You know,
okay.
It'll cook very quickly. The pasta is cooking the whole time.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back on The Chef You and I with Father Andrew Umberg and myself, Catherine Raker. We're back on The Chef You and I with Father Andrew Umberg, and the next dish we're making is actually the salmon dish that you're frying. I've never fried salmon before.
I like it more that way, and maybe,
why?
I don't know, maybe it doesn't work out any other way for me, I don't know.
Okay, that's all right, but you learned how to do it by frying it, right?
Yes, I like it this way, I like
And you didn't to... coat, you don't, go, tell me what you do with it now.
So all I've done so far is put some olive oil into
a
preheated pan.
Right.
And then we're putting a nice generous amount of butter, about a tablespoon and a half.
Okay.
Okay, and we'll get that in there, and we'll mix those two together.
Right.
And then we'll go ahead and move the butter out of the way.
Thank you.
And then I will take some seasoning.
Old Bay.
Yeah, Old Bay, and I'll give this a generous sprinkling.
Ooh.
Yeah, very generous, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, well, there we go. Okay.
Okay.
And then I think that gives it a nice flavor. And then we'll go ahead then and put this in, skin down.
Wow.
And it's nice and hot.
Okay.
Okay, and we can take this away.
I'm going to turn the pan on, Father, if you don't mind.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, so we've got the fish cooking here. I'm going to just use this, okay.
Ooh, that looks
good.
I'm going to
get this in here like this.
Now, how long does it take?
I watch it a little bit. Till it depends on how thick the fish is, et cetera.
Right. Do you need another spatula as well?
I think this will do the trick.
Okay.
I think. Famous last words.
Famous last words. I have another spatula.
Ken, I'm just moving this around because I had it extra hot here.
Yeah.
And I'm just really letting it cook through as much as I can on this side.
Mm-hmm. And that looks really, really good.
See, and now that it's really cooking, it smells really nice too, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. It does smell good.
Yeah.
It smells good.
Okay, and now I think we're to the point
where that you can add the cream sauce to it? No.
Oh, the cream sauce will just go on the pasta. This is a separate dish. Separate dish, yes.
Okay.
Okay. So, I will use this bigger one. Thank you. Okay.
And just turn it over. Ooh, that looks beautiful.
Yeah, I want to get more of the butter and oil actually onto the fish, though.
All
and,
right.
Okay, so here we go.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, that's beautiful.
Yes, and the peel comes off, I mean, the skin comes off for people that don't like to eat salmon skin, you know.
Yeah.
Not everyone does, and that's fine.
That's true.
Okay, I'm going to lift this up and get some of this oil
on
it further down here, yes, and get that.
Okay.
And really cook the end of this nicely. But now,
How long does it take?
I think we've been cooking it, about 2 minutes so far, two or three?
Yeah.
And I'm just going to leave it in here a tiny bit longer. I'm going to turn this down.
Right.
In fact, I'm going to turn it off and just let it coast a little bit here.
Okay.
I'm going to unplug it to make sure we're good there.
Right. And then you're going to put it on a platter?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, and that'll be nice. But before we do that, I want to start cooking these other items again. So I'm going to leave that there for just a moment, and I'm going to turn back up the cream sauce.
Okay.
and we'll add the tomato sauce to it.
Okay, do you need that?
As soon as that heats up, I'm also going to start up the Brussels sprouts. So we'll go ahead and start up this front burner.
All right.
Okay, and again, I've got the oil and the butter and the onion there. Okay.
Okay, and I'm going to give you some marinara sauce.
Okay, great. Okay. And we'll go ahead and we'll serve up this fish. People have different ideas of how lean they like their fish or
right.
not lean, how rare.
Right.
Okay, and then we'll go like this, and then we're gonna flip it.
Ooh.
And serve it like this. I think it's real nice. And I'm gonna get a little bit of extra sauce on it. If we can get maybe a little spoon out, I'll spoon some of that onto there.
Here, I'll do that, and then I'll let me do that.
There we go, and then we've got a lot here in this corner.
Well, in this corner, okay.
Yeah.
All right, and then just spoon it onto it. Here we go.
Yeah, don't burn yourself.
All right. I'm not gonna burn myself.
Wonderful. Okay.
Okay, and then I'm just gonna wipe it up a little.
Okay.
We're gonna take a little break,
okay.
And we'll be right back. We're back with Father Andrew Umberg, and Father, you are doing what now?
I'm working on the Brussels sprouts.
Okay.
We have the onion and the butter
right.
and the oil.
Right.
Okay, and
ready
then
I'm
salting this nice and thoroughly. I'm putting maybe a quarter teaspoon in. That's not super thoroughly, but I'll put a little bit more in.
Okay.
I'll also put in just a dash of pepper. I'm going to take the lid off and really go to town here.
So that's about a quarter teaspoon?
Yeah, and I also put a quarter teaspoon in the salmon and the salmon sauce and about a half teaspoon of salt, and we might need to add a little bit more.
Okay.
Then I'm going to take this marinara sauce.
Right.
And I'm going to throw this in.
Right.
To the
cream sauce.
Yes, the cream sauce. Only a little bit, and you can buy the cheap canned stuff if you want to.
Mm-hmm.
And then it'll be really smooth. But this is nice. It gives it a nice.
Ooh, that's beautiful.
Tomato-y flavor, a little
that
bit more richness,
nice.
And kind of it's kind of a nice pink color to go with the salmon.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, that's why.
Okay, and then we'll go ahead and turn this up a little bit then.
Okay.
I'll turn this back up to get it heated up. If you can pour that pasta into the dish then, and then I've got to get busy with these Brussels sprouts.
Okay, so you want
so
this?
I'm going to grab the...
You want this on a dish?
The Brussels sprouts and
do you want this on
them,
a dish?
No, I want it right in there to finish cooking.
Okay,
so I've got the Brussels sprouts in there.
Okay, can you put this in the sink for me, Father?
Sure.
Thank you. All right, so we've got that in the sink. We've got that actually in the pan.
And now I'm going to mix up a little bit the Brussels sprouts with the butter, see?
Right.
That's getting nice and covered. They're all going to be covered with butter and onion and olive oil. And then we want to really kind of scald them a little bit there. Now, meanwhile, we have this sauce. The sauce has plenty of oil in it.
Mm-hmm.
And now watch. I'm going to just take this nice hot sauce, mm-hmm. and I'm going to put this on the pasta.
Ooh.
Okay, and
you
that's done.
Do
and then, I need to turn off the rear.
Okay,
and I've got the right one.
Ooh.
And if you put that up on the table here, we've got our nice salmon here, and now we'll have our salmon-y pasta with it.
Okay.
And then that shouldn't be too hot. So lots of pink coloring in there. Go ahead and
start
toss it around
putting
a little bit more.
Okay.
And then we'll let it sit a little bit so that can soak in a little bit.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
We can even put it on low heat.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm still working on the Brussels sprouts, and they're cooking away. And I'm going to toss them a little bit more.
Okay, I've got it on low heat.
Not everyone's got a good wrist for this. I've kind of learned how to do this, and I like mixing it. It's so much easier. It's safer than trying to scoop them around
right.
with spatulas at the end of it all.
Right.
Okay, I'm putting in a little bit more salt, another quarter teaspoon of salt.
Okay.
I want to get this all over the Brussels sprouts, make sure that they're all nice and evenly salted.
Right.
Again, butter, salt, and onion. Flavor combination made in heaven. Okay.
Okay.
So there we go. The Brussels sprouts even pop a little bit.
Really?
It's okay if they scorch a little bit. It's okay.
That's
that little
good.
Bit of caramelized flavor is nice on the Brussels sprouts. Okay.
Okay. So we are.
So we've got pasta and ready to go here.
And that's kind of popping, right?
Yeah,
like
the Brussels sprouts are coming along. We'll let those sit a little bit more. Okay, I think now.
I need to get this out real quick.
Okay.
Okay,
yes, the cod is cooking.
Right. We're going to leave that in the oven. It's fine.
Okay. if we can have like a ladle to kind of mix this nicely. When you're heating up this pasta, you don't want to scorch the pasta at the bottom. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
And you don't want to beat up the pasta too bad. So the idea is you just want to turn it enough so that that nice creamy, that creamy salmon-y, onion-y sauce keeps bathing the pasta.
Right.
Okay, and again, the smell here is very nice. The Brussels sprouts don't even smell bad as they're cooking like this, you know.
And while you're doing that, I am going to take a short break, and I'm going to go get the salad and put it together real quick.
Okay.
We'll be right back after these messages on The Chef You and I. We're back on The Chef You and I with Father Andrew Umberg and myself, Catherine Raker. But we're waiting for everything else on the stove to...
Yes, I'm cooking the Brussels sprouts.
Right.
They're really getting scorched now. You can see there's some... little bit of brown or tan marks on them.
Ooh, they look good.
Yes, and they actually almost seem to pop a little bit like corn. I mean, they don't pop all the way up like corn would.
I have to learn how to do that. I have to learn how to do that. Okay, so we're going to make this salad really fast because it's really good and good for you. So what do we want to put in to make the dressing?
You want 2 tablespoons of the pear juice reserved from the pears.
Right, which we did. All right.
And then you want 2 tablespoons of olive oil and vinegar dressing.
I did that. One, two, yes.
Okay, and then season to taste with salt and pepper. You've got your pink salt or that kind of salt.
I'm not going to use this. All right.
And meanwhile, I'm going to take a little bit of water and put it on these Brussels sprouts to have them steam to make sure... they cook all the way, just a couple of tablespoons.
Now I'm going to whisk this together really quick.
Okay, and so you can hear those sizzle then.
Ooh, that smells, and I can't wait to taste that. I can even
see,
eat
that.
See,
now that steam, that'll make sure that all the nooks and crannies, that's why I cut them in half too, so that everything gets in there. Okay.
Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to actually take our arugula.
Okay.
And we're going to actually add the dressing to it, right?
Okay.
And we did that, right?
Okay, great.
Okay.
And I'll take this.
Okay. And we have these really wonderful little things right here I love.
Oh, nice, yes. Nice salad.
And then we're just going to mix that together, toss that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add our cheese, and which is 4 tablespoons of the cheese. And it's really a blue cheese, right?
It is. It's a blue cheese, but a little bit green.
Green,
It's known as green cheese.
And then I made these, Father.
Oh, nice.
These are actually candied pecans that I made on another show, and they're wonderful to keep. And there's like, I think, 2 tablespoons in here. So we're going to add that. And then we're going to add our pears. So I've already halved the pears.
And you're taking them out so that you're not getting more pear juice in there than you want.
Right, okay. That's right. And then I actually, what I did was I refrigerated the plates. So if you put that there.
Very nice. Okay.
I'm going to take this and I'm going to, wait a minute, pardon me. And I'm going to take another little pear like that and a pear like that and do this.
Nice.
Isn't that sweet?
It's wonderful.
Because I'm going to plate it. And this is so delicious. I love this salad. Absolutely. So good for you. Isn't that pretty?
That is beautiful. I'm going to stir the pasta a little bit more just to make sure.
So we're going to do
this.
We've
got a nice hot product here.
Okay, we're going to do one of these. And we're going to take a picture of it. That's really pretty. All right, are you almost done?
Yes.
Okay. So
if I can have the bowl for the Brussels sprouts, that's square one.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and pour those right on in.
And then we're going to serve
be very nice.
And we're going to serve it. So we're going to take a little short break, and we'll be right back. And we'll be back in our wonderful dining room having wonderful entrees and dinner with Father. We'll be right back. We're back on The Chef You and I, and this is the best part of the whole show, Father.
That it is.
Because you get to eat what you make, right? And this is really fit for a king. And I cannot wait to try your Brussels sprouts. I can't wait to try the fish, but I think we need to say grace before we do this.
I think so, too.
So you want to do that? You want to do the honor?
Yes. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Okay, so you want to dig in?
Oh, okay.
Okay, so do you mind if I try these first?
Oh, please, please do.
Well, you know I can't do the fish. Yeah, would you? I'd like to have some fish. Now, you know, Lent's late this year, right? So we can be making all kinds of new dishes before Lent.
That sounds great.
Does that sound great? So I just want, okay, that's good. That's good. Thank you. Mm-hmm. And you got to try my pear salad because it's really good.
I'm looking forward to that.
That's good. So, and I'll give you the pasta.
Okay.
Hold on. This looks so delicious. Can you get it?
Yes, I think I'm doing a little something different with each piece of fish, but that's fine.
That's fine.
Okay,
and I'll go
Here's the Brussels sprouts. How nice.
And then I'll pass you this as well. Okay. Or you could pass me your plate, and I don't know.
That would even be better.
I think it would be better.
Okay. Thank you.
I can't wait to show my kids how to make these. This is really cool. My boys love to cook, by the way. Love to cook. So you just tell me how much pasta you want.
Okay, a couple of nice spoonfuls would be.
Okay. All right.
Maybe one more.
One more. You sure?
That was the first helping. Okay, maybe one more. Okay.
Okay, I got it.
Nice. Thank you.
Okay, I did that. Well, that's the way life is. Sometimes you make a little mess. Okay. But, you know, I'm going to try this, and then we're going to run out of time, believe it or not.
Oh.
Believe it or not. I know
it
you love
fast.
To come and do it.
I love to cook, yes. The time goes fast.
Okay, let's try this. Let me try this. Okay. All right. I love it.
It's light, isn't it? I mean, so you mainly just taste the onion and the butter.
Mm-hmm. These are the best I've ever had.
Thank you.
Excellent. I want to try your salmon because I really like salmon. But unfortunately, my husband doesn't like it. He likes smoked salmon, so we made something special for him tonight, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
We made the pasta. So this is really good. And I also made some sole for him. That's delicious.
Nice flavor, isn't it? Again, it's the onion and the butter and then the Old Bay seasoning with it.
Do you know what? I'm going to do this all the time now. You know, I usually do the salmon in the oven or on the grill, but now I'm going to do this on top of the stove. I love this. This is great. Well, we've come to the end of the show now. And we'll have our recipes on our website. Tell me what you think of that before we go.
Oh, okay. I'm making sure I get a little of everything.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Is that good? And I love
those pecans, those candied pecans.
Oh, those are great. Right.
Wonderful.
And they were so easy to make, so simple to make. And that recipe's up on the website as well. You can go to the Chef You and I, that's the chef, and then it's a U, just like Ulysses, ANI.com, and you'll see all of our television shows up on the Chef You and I and our recipes. And I can't wait to have you back on the show again, Father. And I love your new beard. That's really cute.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. So we'll see you again next time on the Chef You and I. And thanks to all of our sponsors and the Bagwell for providing us with that wonderful Bagwell and everybody else. And thank you again. And we'll see you next time on the Chef You and I. Bon appetit.
Thanks for joining us on the Chef You and I show today. We'll be back next week with another great and healthy recipe. Don't forget to visit our website, thechefyouandi.com, for all of our featured recipes, cooking tips, and clips of the show.